In today's video, we're gonna build an organizational chart using Visio from a pre-populated Excel sheet. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. In this Excel sheet, I have four different columns with a header at the top with name, reports to, title, and department. In this example, I have Sean Sample Boss, Joe Manager, Other Joe, and what's really interesting about this Excel sheet, the reports to column. This is what sort of controls the organizational chart structure. So it's important that you have the reports to information with the correct spelling of the other names in here. We have our title and department. And so you could put all of your organizational people inside of this Excel sheet. And then this is what we're gonna load into Visio. So let's do that now. I am launching Visio, and then I'm going to choose organizational chart from the template. Then select create. And then on the org chart tab, we have the option to import. We want to select information that is already stored in a file or database, select next. We want to use an Excel file, select next. We want to find the location of the file, choose your Excel sheet, select next. And then we have name set to name and reports to set to reports to. Then select next. And we want to add all our information in there. Let's select next, and we're not going to have any pictures, and let's select finish. And here we go. We have our top level element, the CEO, and then we have our Joe Manager and Other Joe. And what's cool about this is we could change the layout. Let's select the layout button, and we can choose different layout options for this information. Now that we have our data, our organizational chart in here, we can be sure to test for things like color contrast, and then simply select Acrobat to create a PDF. And we can open up the tags menu to begin reviewing. Now I will give you the information right off the bat. Documents made in Visio are not exported as accessible PDFs, and there's quite a bit of work we need to do in order to make them accessible, but we will cover that in another video. If you want to take a self-paced course and learn how to make documents like this and others fully accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.